Right, we're back at that Asus. So I did turn it off yesterday. So I'm going to go and change the boot options to boot from a USB. And just going to install Windows 11 on this guy from scratch. Here we are. So don't worry about the view. 4 GB. We're going to do 4 GB that's built on board first. And boot option, we're going to boot from our USB. F10, save changes and exit. So it should boot. You might change the input automatically again from the HDMI. Here we go, it did. I'll bring back the screen. Okay. Hopefully it's booting from the USB. Yes, it is. Okay, so let's do a quick Windows 11 install. Australia install. Yesterday we went crazy with this laptop in terms of let me fix that camera view 1 second and go back to number 5. Okay, that's better. All right, next, custom and install next. Okay, there we go. So we're installing Windows 11 onto this guy and let's see how he will go, whether he will freeze or not. So I've got the external HDMI hooked up. I'm going to disconnect so it doesn't keep disappearing. And we'll let it do that while I clean up my area. I'll mute the microphone for now. All right, we're back. After this, we'll do a mem test and let's see what will happen. We still have their 16 gigabyte RAM, which is over there. This is their 8 gig. Okay. Yeah, if the performance test and benchmark, everything works out fine, we'll release this laptop as fixed. We'll do a mem test, right? Okay. Hello, SureCanDo speaking. All right, it had to link to a Microsoft account, which is fine, everything's fine. And this is the RAM. We got a clean benchtop. Okay, I can't believe it. It's gonna get used automatically immediately by something else, probably. Okay, this is another computer we're selling. Put that on the side. Great, that seems to be up and running. Let's have a look. Teams, yeah, no worries, that's bullshit. Okay, so let's go, let's create a local account. Terminal, yes. Net user, sure can do, add. Okay, net user, Asus, add. Okay, Asus. User ad, okay, net local group administrators can do ad. Okay. Oh, come on. Okay, we'll look it up online. We should already have some drivers already. Should be nice and quick. We can suspect something's not right with the port on the left. We can verify that. So let's go ahead and this PC, C drive, Windows.all, users, Asus, downloads. Let's go. It's already online. Yeah, that's relating to Teams. We can ignore that. That's most likely the GPU drivers. Interesting. Very interesting. Caps lock light is not responding. Power on. That is a very weird behavior. So the ports on the left are not working. I plugged in this mouse. It was working before. Let me try the other side now. Nah, the system is frozen. Here we go. Thankfully, now we can repeat the problem. Okay, here we are. This is our challenge. I feel this part is getting warm. I don't know why. I know there's DC jack circuit thread there, but it's unusual. Yeah, okay, wonderful. As long as it freezes, I'm happy. Now we can find its fault. Probably those NCP chips and the MOSFETs, they're all not related to this issue. Okay, let's have a look at that particularly, those USB, those ports are not behaving like they should. Okay, where should we go from here? Fan is not an issue, LCD is not an issue. This part, it's getting really hot. We know the SSD is there. I just don't trust this SSD. I don't know why, but I don't trust this SSD. See, the problem shows itself after it generated a bunch of heat. Okay, so we can put that RAM back because the same issue presents itself with... that's interesting. So if this RAM goes like this, why is there this liquid mark on the fan, on the RAM? Let's have a look at this. It's a good quality Samsung brand. So this is a cool Samsung chip. The Samsung memory chip. Yeah, okay. That's alright. Nothing serious there. Okay. I don't trust this SSD. Under use or heat, it's kind of... saying see you later alligator. So we're on the verge of being an SSD or let me check that MOSFET out. It's kind of weird behavior, that MOSFET, or weird color if you like. That one. Let me just check quickly its gate to source, etc. See if there is a weird behavior. No power in the system. Okay, that looks okay. Yeah. Okay. Okay, we've got a phone call. Okay, that's an interesting one. All right, 1 second. Okay, that's interesting. That MOSFET is reading as such. Let's try calling them again. That's really odd. Wasn't that a 5 volt rail? Something's really shifty here, isn't it? Like 3 ohms gate to source, it's kind of weird. It's generally from a controller. The MOSFET is going to read fine outside the board. Okay. Before we rule out it is the SSD, the MOSFET. We'll try a different SSD one more time. Try this one. Hello, hi, Mark Sirkan here from Okay, so our problem actually deepens even more. On the new SSD, it's frozen, as you can see. So this tells us the problem is not the SSD. Definitely something on the motherboard, this one. Okay, It's a very interesting problem. Okay. Area that's heating up is here all the time. It's unusual. There's something not right around here. Okay, definitely something is not right. Definitely something is not right around here. It's highly unusual for it to, if you like, heat up on one area. Especially there's no operator, there's no CPU. I mean, CPU is here, but it's this side. Okay. Alright, we're gonna do something different. We're gonna have the system run on the thermal camera. I suspect a MOSFET at this stage. The moment I'm fixing another computer that's running Windows 98. Wow. Okay, we need to find which one is the power button. Because the power button's on the keyboard. Already on. Okay. Oh, okay. It's turning on automatically. Okay, that's fine. Okay, let's have a look. Okay. It's a very complex setup here. Okay. Let's see, anything weird happening? Yeah, that's what I mean. See that? So I think I am spot on with that MOSFET. Let me remove the SSD. Well, I think at least that's the problem. I'll find out. Could be something else. Okay, should be building. Yeah, these are normal. That's normal, that's where the CPU is. It's really worth the power supply I've got. That's really strange. What's going on with this power supply? Okay, let's put that SSD back in. So interesting behavior. Let me plug in another SSD. Okay, this one has good shielding, so we can't see much. Get another one. Hello. Oh, hello! Give me a sec. Okay, so this machine is a real hairball of a job. So, we don't know the solution yet. It freezes randomly, so put a SSD, the RAM back. Let's go ahead and put our own SSD in again. We can see this area freezing, if I'm not freezing, getting really hot. And I was going to try a different SSD, customer came and I had to stop the job. So this job has become a kind of a mess. Let me try and focus on it while I got some time. Okay, so here is another RAM, another SSD, which we're going to now test if the freezing issue occurs on this guy as well. So let's check that out. We're not interested in the freezing, we're interested in that temperature going up in that same particular area. Just curious, and let's see what happens. Okay, let's monitor the performance of this guy and the thermal camera. Okay, let's plug in the power. Thermal camera is coming up. Okay. Okay. So this is all a very normal behavior. Nothing to worry there. So this is all normal, totally normal. The question is, why does the system kind of freeze? That's normal. Okay. So with thermal camera, I can't see anything obvious to focus further using that tool. So let's continue to traditional methods. So let's focus on okay, 1 second. Hey, Sam. Ian, Baba, Sam. Okay. So these are the ones I replaced, right? Let's see what the resistance reads now. That's in voltage mode. We're not gonna read anything of that resistance. Okay, here we are. So we can see that the controller is working fine. That is the way it should be acting. So those MOSFETs are replaced. Have nothing, and there's nothing wrong with them. Okay. That's why I think there is really nothing wrong with this guy, even though he is reading such a resistance. It's a real tricky problem. Why it's freezing? Why is this guy freezing? It's usually power delivery error, issue with the power delivery. No, nothing wrong there. Mr. Super IO, do you have an answer for us? That's the RAM power controller. That's the audio chip. What should we do? Do another test with our own SSD. That's a ground. So this has to touch the ground. There's more ground here. There, there. Okay. Let's do another test of isolation of components, okay. So these are basic essentials, which we will connect only. We will not have Wi-Fi. We will not have an SSD. Solution is the easy one on this one, very easy. But finding it is the difficult part. Okay. Let's plug in the power and let's do a mem test. Just curious to see. What are we going to find? Okay, secure boot is disabled. It should boot straight into the SSD. USB. Damn, I've got to run. Okay. I'll let the recording run or not. Let me see if I've got enough space. Yeah, should be enough. Alright, I'll let the recording run and we'll be right back. i7 10th generation without even a proper cooling system. What gives? Okay. Yes, 20 gigs. Okay. Yeah. Hello, hello, hello. Okay. All right, so it's been running for 52 minutes and no crashes. So we'll continue later on. So the MEM tests ran successfully. No issues with the 16 gigabyte plus the 4 gigabyte on board. Now, do we have an operating system in there? Let me check. Forgot. We have in there no SSD. So let's put in an SSD. We haven't got the Wi-Fi chip. Okay, here we go. So no Wi-Fi chip. See if it will freeze or not. Not freezing yet. H1. So that's a Windows 10. Let's do a shutdown. Okay. Turn it back on. Hello, SureCan speaking. All right, so system should be sleeping unless it's waking up. Okay, it's going to sleep. All right, so it hasn't frozen yet. But this charging is very funny. Let me get another charger, it keeps cutting out. This is not normal. Yeah, honestly, this job has been delayed by so many factors. It's just unacceptable. Okay. It's too loose. 20 volts. That's better, more solid, okay. Okay, I can do better tests now. Okay, so is this the same situation as before? Nope. So this is one of the problems, yeah? 0.569, it's stuck on a limbo. And it is feeling warm here and nothing on the screen. So if I shut it down. Now turn it back on. Same thing again. There's definitely something fishy about this system. I can't put my finger on it yet. So without any additional components, without any we've just got the Wi-Fi and this guy. Let's see how the system behaves without this guy. So we won't know if it's on or not. We'll only monitor through the amp usage. Okay. So it's definitely booting up. 600 milliamps. Okay, be right back. Okay. So, it's stuck at this screen. It's a good sign. Why? This indicates there is a deeper problem. So it is not a Windows issue. Could be SSD issue, like SSD control, SSD power. So what we'll do now is we'll run live OS from the USB and see if we can find the fault that way. We've got KTV USB here. So we're at the BIOS screen and it has not frozen. Okay. I wonder if there is an option here. Okay. What if obtain, we disable that crap? Malfunction. Why would it malfunction? Maybe it means if you boot from a US, if you boot from a SSD that's pre-configured with obtain. So what we're going to do, right, we're going to boot with the AHCI option, get rid of the Intel RAID, and let's do that with our own SSD again. So it's AHCI, which is more standard, more default Windows have drivers for. So even though it freezes with the, without the daughter board connected, so we'll assume this guy is now fine. Let's see how he boots with the AHCI option. Yep, so 680 milliamps, 1.2 with the screen on, 1.7. Okay, so we're not sure if this is going to be reliable or not. So what I'm going to do is connect back the SSD that we had, the client had, yeah, with the Intel SSD, which we put Windows 11 on. Okay, so we need to make sure it hasn't forgotten the setting in the BIOS. So let's go ahead, put the client SSD. Because the freezing also happens before we've had the battery, we'll reconnect the battery. Okay. And we've got to make sure the SATA mode is set to AHCI. Okay. Reboot. Frozen. Amp frozen. It's literally frozen. Check this out. Even the amp meter is frozen. It's crazy. Wow, this is super interesting. What can this problem be? Think of a solution. So Wi-Fi card is definitely out of the question. SSD is out of the question. Now let's try our own 16 GB RAM. Again, frozen. So the Intel RAID has nothing to do with it. The RAM has nothing to do with it. Fan is spinning. Why are you spinning? Froze, like in the Matrix. Time stands still. I have one idea. Now we can see startup settings picture, but it's not going further, it's waiting. Why is everything fucking failing? Same, still. Okay, it's even frozen at the recovery window. Come on. Yeah, idea that I had was probably one of the modules on the motherboard faulty, such as audio chip, maybe. This is a really interesting problem. Let's take another deep look at this board. Oh shit. Alright, so we're going to officially give up on this unit. I'm going to try one more thing, which is to replace the one and two sets of MOSFETs, which I suspect under heat conditions start to play up and not deliver the power required. That's the only thing I can think of. Nothing else. This is one of those really rare ones, beyond my ability at the moment. There may be a cold joint somewhere, I don't know, and I don't want to damage the board further. So let's go ahead and do what I just said, and we'll leave it at that. Works, works. Doesn't, doesn't. No biggie. Let's identify the MOSFETs that we're going to replace and replace them and do one more test, and that will be the end. Okay, so the two MOSFETs are these two. They are the ones that get really hot, which is very normal. It's their job to get hot. It's 0609 and 0609. I already replaced these two and made no difference. So I'm going to go ahead and replace these two with the ones that I've taken out. Unless I've got some more left. Let me check if I've got any more left of the 0609. Okay, so that was in the 406 box, so it was easy to find. Okay, now. Five, six, seven. What are these? Yeah, so I need one. And I need another one. Two of them. Yep, 2406. And 409. I got, yeah, three, so I can take another two. Okay, done. So we've got our MOSFETs. Let's go ahead and remove these two guys. We need to work on an angle like this. So we'll do one set at a time. So that's a 06 and that's a 09. Zero nine. Zero nine got rejected. Okay, 06. Okay, done. Now the next set. These are set number one. I'll put them over there. Okay, here we go. Six and nine. Nine. And 406. Okay, that's all fine. That's the second set on the bottom. Done. While the board is loading, just need to wait for while the board is cooling. I'm just doing a OSX upgrade here on a super annoying machine that is not working. Okay, so that's done. We replaced four critical MOSFETs. Okay. It's paper, that's fine. So one of the reasons why I replaced the MOSFET is when the system has frozen on the thermal camera, I can see these MOSFETs still taking up a lot of power because the CPU is still using a lot of power. CPU is kind of like stuck in a mode. It's like in a limbo. It's stuck. Doesn't know what to do. And that's one of the reasons why I'm replacing. Maybe it's not receiving enough power that it needs. It's an i7 10th generation and it's cooled by this. Ridiculous cooling. Ridiculous cooling system. So. Like you're just a tape. Hello, Chance.
How are you, mate?
Good, and you?
I sent you an email over. I'm not sure if I've got a sign on for WordPress.
Let me have a look at that. When did you send the email?
About
5 minutes ago. I got it now. No, that's just telling you got some updates. There's nothing, no information in there. I need the login details for your WordPress website. Of course, yeah, just say, look, I've got a tech who's going to make a change or something on the website, and I need the WordPress, specifically WordPress login details.
Okay, so that's WP4
for some reply. Not WP4, the WordPress.
Yeah.
Yeah, every WordPress website have a login, control panel login. Login. Easy. Bye bye. Okay. We won't be surprised if it still freezes. So don't forget, it freezes with the Wi-Fi chip in, without the Wi-Fi chip, different RAM, without the daughter board, with the daughter board, different power supply. What else can I say? With the screen, without the screen. And loading Windows 11. Doesn't mean it's all going to work fine. But now we're going to wait for it to, you know, get hot and go mental, etc. So let's see what happens when we open up Device Manager. Okay, no problem. So we'll connect to Wi-Fi anyway. So this is the end anyway. So we're going to... Anchor Windows, okay, let's shut it down. It's frozen already, see? Yeah, this have a definitely an internal problem on the motherboard. Yeah, this is not what I expect from my i7 10th generation. Okay, it is not the MOSFETs. All those MOSFETs replaced, nothing. So we'll call this an end. I'm not going to work on it any longer. Okay, thanks for watching. See you in the next one.
Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to support this channel.